Hello students, welcome back. Today I will explain you the second part of your chapter, The Tsunami. In this part, how tsunami has affected areas of Thailand, this is shown. This story is shown through the eyes of Tilly Smith, a 10-year-old girl. How they were affected by the tsunami waves and how they were able to save their lives. Let us see. Now here is a story from Thailand. The Smith family of Southeast England were celebrating Christmas at the beach resort in southern Thailand. Tilly Smith was a 10-year-old schoolgirl. Her sister was 7-year-old. Their parents were Penny and Colin Smith. So the whole family went to Thailand to celebrate the Christmas holidays. It was 26 December 2004. Deadly tsunami waves were already on their way. They had been triggered by a massive earthquake off northern Sumatra earlier that morning. Already, the tsunami has shown the tremors of earthquake early in that morning. The water was swelling and kept coming in. As described by Penny Smith, she said, "The beach was getting smaller and smaller. I did not know what was happening. I was so frightened and I could guess that something wrong is there. Because the beaches were getting smaller, the water of the sea was rising terribly." But Tilly Smith sensed something was wrong. Her mind kept going back to a geography lesson she had taken in England. Just 2 weeks before, she flew out to Thailand with her family. Before coming to Thailand on holidays, Tilly Smith had attended a lecture of geography in her classroom, and there a video was shown showing the tsunami waves. Tilly saw the sea slowly rise and start foam bubble and forms of whirlpools. She remembered that she had seen in her class in a video of tsunami that had hit the Hawaiian Islands in 1946. The 1946 Hawaiian Island tragedy was shown in that video of classroom. Tilly Smith remembered the geography class and she saw the same thing happening in front of her eyes. The kind of bubbles, the foams, the tremendous rise in the level of seawater was seen in front of her eyes. So she could sense the danger coming approaching them. Her geography teacher has shown her class the video and told them tsunami can be caused by earthquakes, volcanoes and landslides. The reason for causing tsunami were earthquakes, volcano eruption and tsunami. Tilly started to scream at her families to get off the beach. She started screaming, shouting loudly that we should vacate the beach immediately. She talked about an earthquake under the sea. She got more and more hysterical. She was so excited that everyone should run towards the beach. Said her mother, Penny, "I did not know what tsunami was, though." Her mother did not have any knowledge of tsunami, but seeing her daughter so frightened, I thought something serious must be going on. She could sense the danger approaching. Tilly's parents took her and her sister away from beach to the swimming pool at the hotel. A number of other tourists also left the beach within them. Then it was if entire sea had come out after them. I was screaming, run. What they saw that as soon as they vacated the beach and ran towards the hotel, they saw that the whole entire sea was coming behind them. The whole of water, the big, huge, large waves were coming after them. And everybody, all the tourists were shouting, run, run. The family took refuge in the third floor of the hotel, the building withstood the surge of three tsunami waves. The building had already stood up. It had already faced three tsunamis and they took the refuge at the third floor of the same building. If they had stayed back on the beach, they would not have survived. If they got delayed, if they had missed that point, they would have died. All of them would have been swept away by the giant waves of tsunami. The Smith later met other tourists who had lost entire families. Thanks to Tilly and her geography lesson, they had been for 41, Tilly went back to her school in England and told her classmates her terrifying tale. If it was not for the geography lesson taught at school, and she watched very carefully what was taught over there, and how tsunami was caused, how dangerous, how massive it is, they would not have saved their lives, and so many stories would be drowned away. So, when they went back to England, they told, they narrated the whole story of how they faced the tsunami and would got able to come out of it and save their lives. So, children, here the second part ends. Go through the question answers and see if you can come out with the answers. If any doubts, ask me. Thank you.